Once upon a time, there was a railway known as the East African Railways. And in Kenya, there used to be a little branch. Here, a few engines would work, pulling passengers and shunting trucks. One engine, a shan’t, was proud of her little station. She'd often sit in a shed at the end of the siding, where she'd watch trains come and go. During recent months, trains were getting smaller and smaller, till she'd only see one or two trains a day, and they'd only have one or two trucks. One day, she decided to ask what was going on. She didn't expect a reply.
The companies don't use us anymore. We've been replaced. Her brother pouted indignantly. They send it by road now. Poor Nia was horrified.
What about the railway?
Who knows, but I saw some men looking me over the other day. Said I'd be a great museum piece.
More like scrap metal,
she giggled cheekily.
Yeah.
And he puffed away.
Nia tried to keep her mind off the thought of the railway closing, but with not a lot to do, it kept worrying her. Later that afternoon, Lulu, the passenger diesel, came into the station. But instead of her lovely passenger coaches, she was light engine. Out of her cab stood some men dressed in smart suits. They examined the station, then they examined the yard, and then they examined Nia.
Station's far too old, we'll have it knocked down, one man said to another.
The yard will be good for keeping supplies at, though I feel we need a more modern engine to run it.
Lulu was annoyed. Nia is one of the best engines working on this line. You can't replace her.
Yes, thank you.
We'll leave her here till we find something. And with that, they climbed aboard the diesel and headed down the line. Nia was very upset. She was losing her home. The next few days, men arrived and began taking down the trees and signage. Then they started on the brickwork. Soon there was nothing left. Then they turned towards Nia's shed.
We'd best get rid of that too.
Nia was astonished. Where will I sleep? She called out. But her words fell on deaf ears, and before long, Nia's shed was gone too, and the men left, leaving her alone. Nia still waits in her siding, watching trains pass, hoping one day she can start again. But that's a different story.